Hello guys, my name is Diego Pacheco and today I'm gonna do kind of a different video where I want to talk more about blogging and my writing process. So basically several people, talk to me and I kind of have this conversation again and again with different friends. Some people really think like blogging, it could be something that they cannot add value because they're not doing something unique, like creating a language, like let's say Go or making some very unique project. And I think, you don't need to be like a Nobel Prize winner to being able to produce some interesting content because in the end of the day, we all are different and have different experiences and different opinions, and often, with experience, when we capture these experiences, we often have some value there, even if sometimes we don't realize. And I believe, like, if you document these ideas and these experiences, it help you to improve yourself. So it's not only about others, but also about yourself. Definitely, you can make impact in people and help them, either by learning something small like a Linux command, or learning a different language, or learning a different design and architecture technique or pattern. But also, giving perspectives, and also would say kind of inspiring people to go there and produce things. And when we build things, right? When we write software, we are really creating things. So it's really funny that we are comfortable about building software, but sometimes you're not that comfortable about writing, right? Because it's not that different in the end of the day. Is that there's structure, there's patterns, there's ways you can do it, and definitely there's value. And for me, I think after almost I think right now it's 15 years blogging, is a very long time doing it. I realize, I do almost effortless, but not only writing, but in my day-by-day job, if I need to document some solution, I can do it pretty quickly. If I need to do a design, I can write it down pretty quickly. If I need to do some technical documentation, I do it pretty quickly. If I need to do presentations, I can do super fast. I can do sometimes, slide decks in 1 2 hours. It's not like this is like a timing competition, and I'm not trying to show off. It's nothing like that. But it's just saying, there's some interesting skills that you gain when you start to producing this kind of a context that you enhance your ability to, to make presentations, which is really critical if you wanna, be a leader or an architect. You really need to convey information. You need to have clarity, you need to be able to sell ideas, right? To pitch others and to drive in specific directions, right? And that's all useful tools that, when you have this writing process and you keep producing things, you kind of enhance this capabilities, right? So you need to think about as a way to improve not only your abilities to write, to read, and to make presentations, but also to have a clear mind and sense of thought, right? So you basically can think about different concepts and different ideas, and you can express them better. You can be more clear, you can be more direct. And that's all sorts of things you kind of gain when you are in this continuous, blogging, continuous making videos, continuous writing essays and code tutorials. Lots of people have, let's say, preconcepts about coding tutorials. I always found that even if showing something really, really basic and really simple, you always can add value. And one thing I do, I always try to connect things because things are connected in the end of the day. Like, design is connected to tests. Design is connected to architecture. Architecture is connected to team structures. Team structure is connected to features. Features connected to the business. Business connect to value. So there's There's plenty of things connected. It's not like we are in a loose system that everything is floating on the air, nothing like that, right? And when I try to make some videos, some posts, I try to connect these ideas, and I always trying to bring architecture perspective, design perspective. Sometimes I try to bring some innovation or product perspectives. Other times I try to bring agile and, you know, culture or leadership perspective. So I always try to bring my kind of other experiences and connecting things. And I think that's always value there. And that's something that you definitely can start doing. So when I write things, I often do it in waves. I love this metaphor. I love doing things by waves. And I think if you can do things in waves, it's lighter and actually you end up doing things faster, right? So let's say in a week, I do some coding and I, you know, go and practice some programming language or framework, let's say. And then on the next week, I might be doing some reading and some, you know, blogs or books. Okay. Then on the third week, I might record some video. And then on that same week or on the next week, let's say in 4 weeks, then let's say I publish something, right? Then if you look the end content, you might say, oh, that's a lot thing to produce in 1 hour or in 1 day. But actually, I didn't produce that on that moment. That was done way before. And if you keep in doing that, so if every day you kind of are reading, every day you kind of are producing some notes on Evernote, every day if you kind of are making one video here and there, at the end, that's kind of, you know, always learning and always experiment different ways to express your learning, because sometimes we really just learn when we try to express it, when we try to teach others, right? That's why we learn most. And I believe that's huge value, not only for those who are consuming, but for you that are trying to put that out, right? And I think you just gain by doing that. So that's kind of for my writing process. I always do things by waves. I always try to write about things that I think, things about that I'm doing, things about that I'm studying it. So it's always some kind of a work related. And that's kind of my style. And it's okay if you have different style and different approach. If you just want to blog about one thing, you don't need to blog about others. That's kind of me, because I'm more interested in several things, right? And that's how kind of a work. I like to do different things. I like to talk about these different things. And I like to do these things in work and outside of work. And that's my writing progress. So process. So I hope you guys like this. And if somehow inspire you to start blogging, I think that would be awesome. So let me know. See you guys next time. Take care. Cheers.